Goedemiddag allemaal, welkom bij de persconferentie.
Good evening, good afternoon everybody, welcome to press conference.
Nederland en Oostenrijk morgen. Jullie hebben gezien dat Frank de Boer, de bondscoach en Memphis Depay aangeschoven om jullie vragen te beantwoorden.
You've seen that Frank Boer, head coach en Memphis Depay are here
met vragen voor Memphis, zodat
answer all your questions. We would like to start with the questions you have for Memphis Depay. So please, everybody who has a question for Memphis would like to raise the hand so that he can afterwards go to his own business. First question.
En Javier komt Javier uit Giraldo. Spanje, dus ik ben zeer benieuwd wat deze vraag over gaat.
He's from Barcelona, from Spain, so I'm really curious what he will ask.
About how do you feel about being the first on the group? I mean, how important is for you to be the first team on the group C? And I would like to ask you also if we can expect an official announcement of your signing with Barcelona as a Barcelona player, you know, in the next days. Thank you very much.
I will start with your last question.
Je mag Nederlands.
Oh, ik mag Nederlands?
Ja.
Oké, perfect. Ik zal beginnen met je laatste vraag.
Oké, this is perfect. I would like to start with your last question.
Transfer wordt vanzelf
like I said,
duidelijk waar ik zal gaan
the
spelen.
Transfer will be, it will be clear. We have to wait.
Iedereen weet dat ik,
I don't want to tell anything else or say anything more. Everybody knows that during the last period I've been linked to FC Barcelona and let's just wait for it to come and the news will be there when it is. We are now focused on the Dutch team. We would like to finish as the first in the group. That's our goal, that's our objective. So that's the reason why we need to win tomorrow and get 3 points. It's really important to us.
Dan gaan we door naar de volgende in de lijst. En dat is Simon Zwartkruis van Voetbal International. Simon.
Simon, the next question is for you, Dutch magazine Voetbal International. Good afternoon, gentlemen. Question for you, Memphis. Can you tell us anything about Ruud van Nistelrooy as his role as an assistant for you as a top striker?
Een topspits geweest.
Yes, of course, he was a magnificent striker. He's a legend, absolutely.
In de groep zien we hem natuurlijk als een spitse trainer.
As a group, we see him as our coach for the strikers, or as the assistant to the coach. He helps us out during the training, as well as during our free time. Okay, Alexander, thank you. He has a lot of experience, and he takes us with us in his experience. Now that you've changed the system, what is his role in that?
Maar zeker als hij wat.
Of course, he, the last decision is for the head coach, but yes, he's always very clear to us when he would.
Ja, hij is natuurlijk
to,
met de
to us
bezig.
Or for the group, dus, he is really important, especially for us the forward players.
Simon,
he has a really important role for us all. Next question for Valentinus Driessen, Dutch newspaper De Telegraaf. The first phase, the group phase, has almost finished. All the countries have played the game. What's your opinion about this group phase? And who should be in the final, according to you?
Je ziet dat volgens mij heel veel wedstrijden dat er pas in de tweede helft doelpunten vallen.
As you see in a lot of matches, the decision is there in the second half. The first half is almost in all games really closed. And you watch these games where there are opportunities, and the first half, almost in every game, like for example yesterday in France, the guys started to defend, and it's okay for them, they know they have the qualities to have a counter-attack, so in the final, well, we would like to beat them, but to be honest, we want to beat everybody, it's not important who will be the opponent. Thank you, Valentine, and then we change to Sjoerd Mossu. Memphis, have you been calculating now that what would be the best schedule for you to continue?
Ik weet niet, trainen.
Ja, laten we eerst.
I'm not sure, the coach maybe for you. Let's first start by winning this match and afterwards we will see. Tomorrow is an important game.
Ik had gezegd, ik benader elke wedstrijd op zich.
Like I always said, each game we have to focus it in its own way and so play our game by game and start the tournament like that. So now the focus is all is on Austria. What would you like to improve when you compare to the last game against Ukraine?
We begonnen heel goed. Ik denk als je in die eerste.
We started out really well. If you can analyze the first 15 minutes and you can score a goal, then it would be very. It would be more easy.
Maar uiteindelijk de tweede helft.
So yes.
Ga je naar een 2-0, als je dat dan vast kan houden.
Second half, the 2-0, if you are able to continue that and maintain this score, then you have to make 3 of 4-0. But I think that we have to start well and it's a good signal, that would be a good signal.
Volksland, Willem.
Willem Vissers, next question. Memphis, this solo you made in the first, second minute like that, I'm not sure which minute you did that. How tough is doing so for you? I think it's one of the most difficult things to do in football. How long do you need to recover from such a sprint? It was really early in the game, so yes, I was absolutely exhausted after that. But you don't have a choice, you need to go for it.
Nou ja, het was wel zwaar.
Give everything. Maar yes, it was tough. Ben je op jacht naar een doelpunt? Are you looking for a goal doing when you do that? You have scored 3 goals in the preparation so far and you are the player that everybody's focused on. In what way are you looking for a goal? Or in the second half it seemed almost like, well, that's your role. You need to try, of course, but where is the balance between trying to find a goal and also look for other players when you see that they have a better position? I think the balance is in my game, in the way I play. And this is the way I do it. I try to find that balance. I'm a player with a lot of risk in it. And this is the way I like to play. Sometimes I lose the ball. In the second half, yes, you are right. I lost the ball more often than normally. And maybe then I need to focus on maintain ball position. But I am always looking for a goal and or to give an important pass for the goal, the assist. And you need to close the game as soon as possible and try to look for more space on the right side. As you've seen, there was more space on the right side of the pitch. Can you still hear me, Willem? The other one can hear you.
Sorry, Willem.
On to the next one.
Willem has left the building. Let's go to the next question. Two more questions for Memphis than he is, believe. Hello, Memphis. One question for Belgian press. I know you and Lukaku know each other really well. How good do you know each other? What do you expect from him during this tournament? And are you proud of him after what he's done when he had to leave from Manchester United? So he developed in a good way. But yes, I know him really well. The response I've spoken to him one day before the tournament, and I expect from him what he showed during the tournament. He scores in a way effortless and really easy. He has a lot of confidence. We have a good relationship. I've been playing against him since I was a young player, so I know him really well. And in Manchester United, I think he did really well as well. I don't think he had to leave. I think he wanted to leave. And he showed his quality even now in Inter and as well in the Belgian team. I think he has the record of goal scorer.
Dat weet hij.
So I'm really proud of him, but
tussen het toernooi wel spreken elkaar.
I will talk to him during the tournament. Yeah, so we speak each other quite often. Thank you for the question. So the last question, Thijs, is for you, for Memphis. Memphis, good afternoon. Now that we are on the way a few games and we're here in Portugal, you're one of the few players who have been through a lot. When you compare it to other tournaments, for example 2014, how would you describe the atmosphere or the differences?
Wel overeenkomen.
When you look at the atmosphere in the group, I think it's comparative. Really sharp doing the training. The group atmosphere is really good.
Ja, we zitten er goed in, dus dat kan ik met elkaar
vergelijken. Yeah, we're good in the tournament, so you can compare this to each other.
Dus dat is wel anders.
We've had less time during the preparation, but...
WK in Brazilië, dat is anders ook.
Dus, then you played the World Cup in Brazil, which is completely different playing here. And now that we're really happy seeing the fans again in the stadium, this gives us a very special feeling. It's great to see so. And these are the differences. There you play with 50, 60,000 people. Maybe now there are 16,000. So yes, it's a difference.
In ieder geval de eerste drie wedstrijden hier in je eigen land te mogen spelen.
But to play in our own country, three more games in our own country, yes, that's great. Thank you very much, Memphis. Now we continue with questions for Frank de Boer. Now that you are here, Thijs, the journalist. Now, if you have a question for the head coach, Frank, good afternoon. Will Matthijs de Ligt play? Yes, he will play. No doubt about it? No, no doubt. Did you see any doubt in my eyes? Or? Can you tell us who will be the player not playing on being on the pitch tomorrow? Then no, I cannot tell you. Hi, good afternoon, Frank.
Afgezien van de doelpunten die je zondag tegenkreeg, wat waren voor jou nu de belangrijkste lessen?
Besides the goals, what were the most important lessons you had during the game? What did you learn from the last game?
Eigenlijk de eerste helft heel veel controle hebt. Natuurlijk zijn er ook in de eerste helft.
Half we controlled the game. There were some moments though where they could hurt us.
Niet echt veel op.
Or
die momenten die
did not reach to a goal, but we have to minimize those opportunities for the opponent. And then you're focusing on the defense. What do you do when there's a counterattack? Where is the defense? Are you anticipating on the new situation, or do you see that Memphis is moving again? Is he making an attack? Like we've spoken before, well, you can give him the ball, you need to look for more space. The players close to him, they have to think about playing high pressure. So you have to think that maybe I get the ball, hope for it. So these type of ideas, yes, I've been focusing on that. This should be better the next game or tomorrow. And in ball position, we need to be more comfortable.
Die verbeterd moeten worden en dan is het vaak als je die
I think that
ziet,
the when you take a look at the things you need to improve.
Kwestie van communicatie, binnenkant houden, beter.
It's communication when you look at the mistakes. It's defending, maintaining your own player, marking.
Weet je, dus dat soort dingen, ja dat.
By stepping forward too soon.
Twee goals schenken aan de tegenstander. Maar het gaat me vooral om die
you
momenten.
You should
van,
not give away these two goals. But it's all about the moments right before. Dat, and the way you change or switch from ball possession.
Dit toernooi, het werd net ook al even aan Memphis gevraagd.
Another question is during the tournament. We always also ask Memphis. What is your, in your opinion, what have you been noticing during the tournament in a way in the trend in this?
Nee, je hebt altijd een team die probeert het spel te maken en andere.
There is always a team that is trying to play its own game and try to make the game in its own style. And you have when you play against them doing so, then you need to take advantage of that.
Je hebt altijd het verschil tussen als je het verschil ziet tussen Spanje en Zweden is natuurlijk immens.
If you see the if you take a look at the differences between Spain and France, they achieved the what they wanted. Spain wanted to dominate and create opportunities, score a goal.
Zijn ze aan een 0-0 aan het vechten eigenlijk en over een gelijkspel.
And the opponent was fighting against these draws 0-0, you have to say. And I think it's always been like that.
You look, niet echt, denk ik, nou,
there are several systems or ways we play during the tournament, so no, I don't think there are that many differences to other tournaments. Good afternoon, Frank.
Even twee dingetjes.
Two things.
We zijn nu inmiddels al gewend dat hij erin staat.
Wout Weghorst, we are used to see him play now. But it came all out of the blue.
What is now for
you've played with him in March, but what has been the key factor, or why did you decide to let him play? Maybe it was his personality, or you know, during the start of the tournament or preparation, I didn't want to change that much my own selection. I had a good feeling with all the players, so at that moment, did you want to play with the guys who were qualified, and that's the way you continue? Now I could bring some more players with me, and then there is the opportunity to give this player on this opportunity. So I think when you look at his preparation, or you see his matches, and before the tournament, I preferred Luc de Jong striker, but now I decided for Wout, since he showed really good. He performed really well the last months, and I know what we. I think he deserved it. You know what he can bring the team. But against a really good opponent, no, he did not disappoint it. So I think the decision was quite. Marcus, the question is yours.
Vorige keer hadden van het vasthangende knopje van mute en unmute.
There is no problem mute and unmute. I can hear you, Matthias, so Enzo will change to you. I'm sorry, Matthias, we will get back to you later.
Dag Frank, goedemiddag.
Good afternoon, Frank. We need to focus during the whole tournament. We've only had one game. The atmosphere in the whole country is pretty good, but it can change.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah, I don't know.
Sorry, it looks like the journalist has left.
Het systeem is nog niet onvolprezen goed, helaas.
The system is not that good we are using, so I'm really sorry. I cannot unmute you.
Bakker van nu.nl.
We changed to Ripkip from Dutch newspaper Nu. Can you hear me, Frank?
Ja, je zal ze inmiddels uitgebreid bekeken hebben, Oostenrijk.
You've analyzed them, I suppose, Austria. What do you think of them? Well, they have made a really good impression. They can play via several systems. They've played 4-3-3, but against the other opponents who had the same idea of playing, Northern Macedonia, for example, they had three defenders. Lava in the center. They have a good team. Many players from Red Bull.
Full gas football.
They always play high pressure, full gas. But also their mentality is good. No, I don't think it will be an easy game. What do you expect? The same. That they we should have or dominate and should be.
It is gewoon afhankelijk zeg maar van onze kwaliteit.
No, we of course want to make our own game, but it's really important to play. And I think we have to play high pressure and push them backwards on the pitch. To do so, we need to be focused. I think that they will give their best of them to make this a hard game. So I might expect a few things comparative to the game against Ukraine. And now that you mentioned De Ligt playing on the left side of the pitch, should he be worried? Yes, I think so, when he has to be there. And does he need to do so? We will see that tomorrow.
Ik snap best wel dat hij daar niet heel prettig.
I understand the reason why he's not so comfortable playing on that side of the pitch.
Geen lekkere uitgangspositie voor hem, zeg maar.
So it's not the best way to start. So of course I take this into account. That's normal.
Maar onderbelasting kan ook een gevaar zijn. Niet alleen overbelasting, maar onderbelasting. Was dat een van de redenen om bijvoorbeeld die twee wissels te doen in de 67e minuut?
What were your reasons to substitute these two players last game? They were tired? Sure, yes, we also did it Wijnaldum and Frankie. They just got back from. They played 30 minutes. tournament is long. So we cannot take any risks. Sometimes you have to do so, but I think it's also a good thing that you need to take everything into account. And you know that you have good players on the bench. So if you bring them too much and they give too much of their energy, we need to also take into account their physical status or the power that can have. And the five substitutes that we can bring in now is a big advantage, definitely, when you refer to this. So you can change more and you can start with other players, or when you substitute two players, you have only normally one. Now that you have three more, it's definitely more options, so this is good. We change to Austria now. Planet Titan, your question.
Hier leken toch alle seinen op groen te staan, Frank, hè?
Ja. Maar noem maar Enzo, want die...
Zullen we Enzo nog eens proberen? Want Hubert.
It seemed that everything was okay to ask a question on the Planet Titan, but we cannot hear you, so we change now, Enzo.
Dus daar gaat toch iets niet helemaal goed nog?
No, I think some problems are here. I think it's going better than the last time, but Enzo, are you here? And head coach is asking.
Tot nu toe was het een hoopvolle sessie. Enzo, ga je gang. Want ik denk dat jij ons wel hoort.
Enzo, go ahead. I think over de focus, I will ask you a quick question then.
Van de mening in het land.
Do you try to protect the team from all the opinions in the country? No, that would be a utopian situation that is impossible, but I think that we are trying to achieve something and focus on this and not to...
De een zal wat meer tot zich toenemen dan de ander.
Some players will focus on these public opinions more than others, but during this tournament, or even starting in October, we've been starting to be here. And you mentioned the word focus, from game to game, live from game to game. I hope that everybody understood this idea, and I think actually that we did well. We've only been on the way one game now, so you can never forget everything, or you can not confront everybody with the opinions from the outside or the country's opinion, but we try not to focus too much on it. I think that we can all hear the press from the Netherlands, but it seems that the foreign press is harder to understand. We try. Lars, could you ask the question?
Microphone. Yeah. Yes.
Can we on?
Yeah.
De UEFA heeft even bekendgemaakt dat Arnautovic is gechozen voor de wedstrijd.
Arnautovic is been chosen.
De situatie tegen Macedonië. Yeah. Wat denk je ervan?
Because what is your opinion about the situation with Arnautovic? Did you understand that he's suspended for the game? I haven't seen what happened. I saw that there was an investigation going on, but I'm not sure what happened, or I couldn't see. I thought he was doing something with the players from North Macedonia. I think it's a shame for Austria, because he's a good player. I know him from his period in FC Twente, so yes, he's a good player, and I think they will miss him. In that way, for us, of course, it's an advantage. And he came in as a substitute and he marked the difference right away.
Dankjewel, Lars. Nou wil ik nog eens kijken of Hubert Giegler van de Kleine Zeitung ons inmiddels...
Let's try again. Hubert Giegler, Kleine Zeitung. Zeitung. Second opportunity. Can we hear you now?
Tevreden aankijkt, maar niet de indruk wekt dat we ook daadwerkelijk met hem aan het praten zijn.
You are looking at us, but you don't seem to notice that we are talking to you, right?
Valentijn.
Then we go to Valentijn.
Frank, kan Timber morgen de slingers ophangen?
Can Timber decorate his home to start a celebration?
Hij is jarig.
Why would he do so? Well, it's his birthday, so that's the reason why you should decorate your house. Maybe you would like to put some more. Why not? Well, we will see that tomorrow.
We zijn zeer tevreden.
He is doing great. We are really happy with him.
los van de individuele kwaliteiten van Frankrijk, heb je ook niet gegruweld van het spel?
Besides the individual qualities of the French team, that you find it awkward that with so many talent on the pitch, they are not playing ball possession. Well, they have a good talent forward on the pitch, so they were playing high on the pitch, taking advantage in small spaces. And making some hard decisions.
By the goal, in geval,
when you saw that pass from Pogba, when the goal came, I think they did well. I will also play well.
Maybe it's not
something that we are used to. But on the other hand, I can also enjoy. I can also enjoy these tricks some players pull out. It's their decision, and I think that it will bring them far in the tournament. But as a world champion, don't you think that they have some kind of obligation playing or with these talents? No. They are right to do so. If they think that this is the way they play best, well, they should.
Dan zijn ze heel moeilijk te verslaan.
Dankjewel, Valentijn. Dan gaan
we think they are really difficult to beat, so no doubt about it. Last question, John Graaf. It's for the foreign press, we were hoping you could ask a question, but there were some technical issues, and we hope that you can forgive us, because we don't know anything what we can do about it.
Dan verstop ik er 2-1.
Well, then two questions in one. I will try to do so. First, about the left side of the pitch. First, we tried with Wijndal and Van Aanholt. I was wondering, what did you think last Sunday? Why did you decide to change them? And second question is, how do you look at the way the country changed the national opinion about the team? That first it was really poor, but now that you won, it's all positive. About Owen and Patrick Van Aanholt, I think it's clear. Patrick is doing better now. So yeah, that was the reason to bring him. Owen is also improving now. So I think this is good. This type of competence in the team is normal.
Nou, niet een voorsprong, maar in ieder geval, ik zal je niet zomaar bij de eerste, de beste moment, zeg maar,
I don't substitute you or let you down after one deception, so no, but during a longer period, I've been thinking about it, and we need something else at this moment. I told him, I also told Owen that he needs to show that he is ready. And I think he will make his minutes during the tournament. Last Sunday. From now on, he needs to show that he's ready, he's good enough. And Patrick, well, he's doing great now. And about the last thing, the switch in the country's opinion. Well, if we have a bad result against Austria, then it will change again. So what we need to do is believe in what we are trying to achieve. This is what we need to teach in a way to our group as well and staff entirely. I think we are doing so, but yes, I'm confident. And I think it's beautiful that the people see this as well. And it's a good thing. Like I said, the news, everybody will see it, everybody gets it. Maybe for one player it has more influence than another, and some players can deal better with it. But it's harder for my wife than for me. So the same thing is going on with players. One player can deal with it easily, and another player starts to think about it. So let's hope that it will stay like this, so it means that we are achieving a good result or getting further in the tournament. Thank you very much.